Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Ramadan Reflections with Kashif Shahzada. In some verses of the Quran, the word kitab has been used in its singular format. And from that basis, some individuals have inferred, rather they've made it sort of a religious belief that there is only one kitab, there is only one book. For example, in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse 213, we read, كَانَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا فَبَعْثَ اللَّهُ النَّبِيِّينَ مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْزَرِينَ وَأَنْزَلَ مَعْهُمُ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ. That mankind was one single nation, and Allah sent prophets as warners and as givers of good news, and with them He sent the book, He sent Al-Kitab. The word Al-Kitab is in a singular in this verse. Can we infer from this that there is only one book that Allah has revealed in all times? The answer is no. We see in the Quran many instances when Allah uses the singular word, a singular noun, as a representative of the plural. The Quran has many such statements, and it is a common feature of language itself. When we speak in a language, then we use some nouns at times which are singular in the sentence but which represent the plural. For example, if somebody says in English that they will be dealt with in accordance with the law of the land, the people will be dealt with in accordance with the law of the land. In this sentence, I've said that the people will be dealt with in accordance with the law of the land. The word law is in singular. But does this imply that there is only one rule in the land? No. There are many rules, there are many laws that are within a country. A country has a constitution, it has many laws. But just one word, one singular noun is used, and it refers to, it incorporates all the plurality of those laws. So it is in this sense that we use this term. You use a singular noun, but it represents the plural. The Quran has many examples of this. For example, we read in the Quran the command, Aqimus Salah, establish prayer, establish Salah. The word Salat is in singular. Does this mean that there is only one prayer, that Muslims are to perform only one prayer in a day? Do they conclude by the command, by reading the command, Aqimus Salah, that there is only one Salat? No, definitely the answer is no. The word Salat is a noun which is inclusive of all the prayers. The order Aqimus Salat covers all the prayers, the five daily prayers in a day. It covers all the prayers, because we read in the Quran elsewhere that there are more than one prayer. There are salawat, the plural form of salat. Salawat has been used. We read in the Quran in Surah 96 that Allah is one. Allazi allama bil qalam. He is the one who taught by the pen. In this verse, the word qalam, which means pen, is in singular. Does this mean that there is only one pen in the world? Because the words kalam has occurred in singular. So, by the logic that some individuals are giving, there should be only one pen. Such would be a stupid suggestion. The singular is used as a representative of all the pens. It does not mean there is just one pen. The Quran has many examples. I could go on and on. It says, for example, وَكَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَا حُكُمًا عَرَبِيًا. Likewise have we sent down حُكُمًا عَرَبِيًا. A hukum in Arabic. the word hukum, which means command in Arabic. But does the Quran contain just one hukum? Does it have just one command? The answer is no. The Quran has many ahkam, but one word in the singular has been used to refer to it. So similarly, many verses in the Quran, we read kitab, the word kitab in the singular sense. It does not mean that there is only one book. The word kitab in the singular, al-kitab in the singular, is representative of all the books, all the kutub that Allah gave to His prophets, Allah sent down to His prophets. That is, it is a common occurring theme within the Quran. Al-kitab refers to the scripture that Allah revealed, that Allah sent down to all the prophets, containing all the commands and the laws and the narratives from time to time. One word is used to represent them from all. I hope that we engage with the Quran and we pray to Allah that Allah gives us guidance and the correct understanding of His book. Thank you for listening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.